A look there at a sold-out crowd that's been whipped into a frenzy. It's Game 3 of the American League Division Series between the American League's Houston Astros and the Cleveland Indians. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian welcoming you to our exclusive postseason coverage on MLB Network. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
And you got to figure here in a five-game series, the odds are long for coming back when you're down 2-0. But hey, it's not impossible. It's been done before, but you can bet the other guys are hungry to end this thing right here and now to give themselves a couple of days off before the next series. This should be a good one.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now, your Cleveland Indians.
Quickly now, we'll look at the two guys who'll get the ball here in Game 3. Now here's a look at the Astros starting lineup. Anybody catch your eye, Dan?
Well, you really have to appreciate what Jose Altuve brings to this team. I mean, this guy is a career 300 hitter. You talk about consistent. He delivers a good at-bat and clutch hits basically every time he walks into the box. I love watching this guy.
Mike Clevinger gets the ball in Game 3 of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Mike Clevinger, big, tall, skinny guy, 6'4", about 215 pounds, three-pitch mix, not overpowering, good slider that's anywhere from 86 to 88 miles an hour. His fastball in the low to mid-90s, needs the changeup, not a strikeout-type pitcher. If Clevinger is on, you'll see a lot of ground balls early on.
Here's how the Indians are setting up on D. I want to focus on the bringer of rain, Josh Donaldson, playing third base, not only from the offensive side as he evolutionizing the game with his new swing path. He'll also dive into the stands defensively to save a run for his pitcher.
Leading off the afternoon for Houston, third baseman, Alan Rudolph.
First offering on its way. Underway at the ballpark this afternoon as the first pitch is in there for strike one. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. The temperature here at first pitch, a very seasonal 63 degrees this afternoon. Outside, 2-1. On the ground to the right side. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Batting second, first baseman number 10, Julian C. Gurriel.
Strike down. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Breaking ball in for a strike. Past history with Mike Clevinger. He's 1-for-3. One out, nobody on. A ball and a strike to count to the Astros first baseman. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Patrick Johnson.
You know, D-Roll, Patty Johnson, you know, decent strike zone, but isn't always super consistent. I think that's one of the things that irritates players and pitchers.
Yeah, you're going to see a few glares, not only from the offensive guys, but maybe the guy on the mound as well. He needs to be a little bit more consistent.
2-1. Easy there, big fella. 2-2. Line drive to center field. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Man, that's a nice job by the batter right there, keeping the front side in. Not easy on a curveball. Would have been easy to throw to front side and hook that foul, but he was able to stay inside and drive it for a base hit.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Man at first for him following the one-out single. First delivery to him on the way. And the curveball is chopped foul right at the plate. It's strike one. Gurriel leads off first with one away. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. The second for one. On to Encarnacion, but it's too late to get them both. Here's Carlos Correa now. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away.
MVP! MVP!
Before the first pitch, a check at first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless. He broke out the slide step there, Danny.
Yeah, he's clearly thinking about the steal right here. Didn't happen, but the cat-mouse game continues on.
And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Two-out base runner aboard in the top of the first. Able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now.
And that fastball away there almost works like another pitch out. I think they're definitely worried about him over there.
He's set and the 2-1 pitch. Strike called. Now the throw down. Not in time. He's in there at second. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. One left for Houston, and now the Indians will see what their bats can do in a scoreless ball game. And with that, let's get a look at the starting lineup for the Indians. Mark DeRosa, how do they go about keeping this series alive?
Matty, I love the way this lineup's constructed. Talking to the manager before the game, he focused on the fact that they have a pass-the-baton mentality. Everything's flowing for this lineup. Chances to score a lot of runs.
Dallas Keuchel will do the pitching in game 3 of the series.
What's your take on him, Dan?
Dallas Keuchel is a complete pitcher. He's kind of a throwback to a Jimmy Key kind of pitcher, a Tom Glavine type, not overpowering, 89 to 91 miles an hour with sink. Has the curveball, has the slider, and the straight changeup. What makes Dallas Keuchel so good, he'll throw all four of his pitches at any point in the count.
Time for a look at the Stros on D. And I want to focus on Jose Altuve. Pound for pound, the best player in big league baseball. A gold glove second baseman, he can do it all. Five tools, the ability to turn a double play with the best of them.
Digging in, Michael Brantley. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the first pitch to him. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball here, 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. Hit on the ground is short.
Correa
has it. And an offline throw, but boy, look at him stretch out and keep the foot on the bag. Great concentration there for the first out.
Center fielder, Jason Hepner.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now a first pitch changeup here. Too far inside, it's 1-0. High strike there, and it's 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out.
Swung on and fouled as it looked to make it all the way up into the concourse area.
The 1-2. Count still at 1-2. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone.
Come on.
Striding in for the Indians, Jose Ramirez. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first.
Ramirez.
Keuchel sets his sights. First pitch on its way. And the first pitch is chopped foul at the plate at strike one. Two out, nobody on.
Nope.
And it's 1-1.
Got a ball, one strike.
This is on the ground over to first. Gurriel picks it up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Indians go down 1-2-3. And this to the plate now is the designated hitter, Tyler White, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. Here comes the first pitch. And the changeup is way low that time. And a fastball just a bit up. White, a 27-year-old. He was taken in the very late rounds back in the draft of 2013.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
And here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Maddie. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Evan Gattis now standing in as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Gattis, or El Oso Blanco as he's referred to in Latin American countries. He was selected in the 23rd round back in the 2010 first year player draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
The 1-1. Takes a pitch for strike number two.
We're seeing quite a few pitches up from him right now, and that can obviously be dangerous. A called strike there, but he might need to lower his sights a little bit.
No score here as we play inning number two. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Number nine, Marwin Gonzalez.
Next up for the Stros, Marwin Gonzalez. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he takes a pitch right down the middle. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded to first. Taken in by Encarnacion. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Astros. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score.
Third baseman, John Donaldson.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And he takes ball one. Head-to-head passed with Dallas Keuchel. He has seven hits in 24 at-bats. He's taken him deep once. Donaldson awaiting the 1-0. 1-1 the count. Now the 1-1 pitch. His fastball that misses. One pitch is a fastball off the plate away, and it's 3-1 now.
I understand pitching carefully to this guy in the box, but the man on deck doesn't represent any relief either. He's gonna have to go after one of these guys.
Full count, 3-2. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. And they will get, no, he's in there, a very close play at first.
You know, D-Row, as a pitcher, that can be so frustrating. You're taught to try to go out there and make quality pitches, and that was a really good pitch, and I would be willing to bet you he's surprised that that turned into an infield single.
Yeah, at the end of the day, he's smiling. That hitter's smiling, running down first base, knowing he's got an infield single right there. He has no business. He'll line out probably 15 times, but it won't even out. You take him when you can get him.
The 0-1 pitch is taken for strike two.
Pretty unusual that you see a 5-0 hitter take two strikes in a row. Typically, those are some of the most aggressive batters in the lineup.
Sent out to straightaway center field. Springer has a read on it. One away.
Batting sixth, right.
Here's
fielder,
Melky Cabrera.
Melky Cabrera.
first pitch on its way. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Hey, you know what? You could slowly start to see that batter leak out over the plate. That was three straight pitches on the outer half. And he was able to dive out there and get an opposite field single. Nice job.
Edwin Encarnacion now. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. Head-to-head passed with Dallas Keuchel. Just a 3-for-13 batting line. Fastball at 88 that time, a ball and a strike.
He might want that pitch back up and away. That's a pitch you can really drive if you have the right approach towards that opposite field gap.
Changed things up on him and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
In a double play situation, that's the location you want a guy to swing at. More than likely, he's going to beat it into the ground.
The 1-2. Very weakly on the ground. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes. The 1-2. And he fouls this one off.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. And a terrific effort out there as he's able to chase that a long way for the second out.
Batting eight.
And that will bring up Eric Gonzalez. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. First delivery to him on the way. Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attack in a philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and exit velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinking fastball for fear that guys are just going to run their barrel into it. Not the case with the high fastball.
Donaldson at second. Cabrera on at first with two down. Balls and two strikes now.
34 pitches for him through an inning and two thirds right now. That's not terrible, but it's a lot higher than he'd like.
2-2. Swung on and missed strike three. Indians strand a couple. We'll move to the third with no score. Back from Progressive Field as we're set for the beginning of the third inning here on the show. In now, George Springer, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Here comes the first pitch. Swing and a little tapper. And he misses with it, 1-1.
Looked like he was trying to work in a front door curveball there, but it seemed like it popped out of his hand a little early, causing it to miss inside.
1-2 as he chases the slider.
I can feel the breeze all the way up here.
Got him swinging in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Springer is retired, and there's one away.
Right fielder.
Stepping up now, number three. He'll get his first shot with the bat here. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And that misses inside, 1-0. Third inning, no score to this point. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1.
I like that they went away with that pitch right there. They really tried to tie him up on that previous pitch, so he was probably what we call inside conscious. He didn't get a strike there, but I'm guessing he was looking for another ball in.
The 3-1. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Wow, you know he's not happy with that call. When it crossed the plate, it sure looked like a strike to me. Seemed to catch a ton of the plate. That's a tough way to give up a walk, but he's got to put it behind him now.
Throw over to first, and he just manages to get his hand in. And that'll bring up the former first-rounder, Alex Bregman. No balls and one strike. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Oh and one, here it comes. And he watches one dip low and inside for a ball, 1-1. Now a move over to first, and the runner back. Runner at first here, one man out. Runners on the move for second. And that jammed him a bit there as it's fouled at the plate. Working for the punch out and the offering. That misses and we're even at 2-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Set and the 2-2 pitch fouled away. Runners on first with one down. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Well, a 3-2 count and a guy that handles the bat up at the plate. This is a great time to put that runner on first in motion.
Another full count pitch on its way. Fouled off. The next 3-2. And he misses again here. It's ball four. And that's back-to-back walks here with one away. Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Weak chopper up the line. That's a foul ball. A one count. Here's the pitch. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
Clearly wasn't ready for the fastball because it was pretty much center cut and he couldn't pull the trigger. Might have been looking for another curve.
The 0-2 delivery. And this is chopped foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2.
When you have two strikes on you, As a hitter, if you get something that you can handle, you have to find a way to do some damage with it. That was a missed opportunity.
And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning. So it's first and second with two men gone. And striding in, the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve.
On,
50th pitch of the game on its way. No balls and a strike to count. Two down, runners at first and second. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2. Altuve takes the swings from the right-handed batter's box, but he's one of those rare hitters that actually thrives facing same-handed pitching. One of the very best in the game, as a matter of fact, in that type of matchup.
Yeah, Matty, he does not leak with that front side. He keeps that shoulder tucked, stays inside the base.
This ball gets down. Let's see if they try to score. Now the relay home. And not in time as the run scores.
Boy, Dero, so close to getting the strikeout there. Needed to make one more pitch and didn't throw a good enough breaking ball there with two strikes.
Yeah, and that's what you pray for from an offensive standpoint. You try and pick up that red spinning dot that constitutes slider coming in there, and then you hope it doesn't fall off the table. He was able to get himself inside that baseball and get a ribby hit.
That's a ball.
There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one.
Hey, I know there's a lot of game left, but that is such an important run there in the top of the first. Try and silence this crowd. I can't tell you, in postseason play, one run feels like three or four.
And a fastball runs a bit inside. He's down 2-0.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here, so the pressure is on right now to get back in the strike zone.
The 2-0 on the way is taken. Strike one.
That's a nasty pitch right there. You got to tip your hat as the hitter. You get a nasty slider like that, there's nothing you can do. Actually, a quality take.
Astros shortstop in front with a 3-1 count. Tyler White would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Set. Here's the 3-1. Grounded back up the middle. Reined in. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. Astros forced to settle for only the one run. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. Astros now batting Roberto Perez. He'll begin things here against Dallas Keuchel.
Roberto Perez.
First pitch on its way. And he gets the call that time for strike number one. Behind 0-2 now. A 1-2 count to the Indians catcher. Ball two.
2-2.
High in the air out to center field. Springer on the run, and that's the first out of the inning.
Left fielder number 23, Michael Brantley.
Now at the plate, Michael Brantley. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. First offering on its way. Knee-high slider that he takes a look at. And that one stayed up a little high. Brantley, 30 years of age. He was selected in the seventh round back in 2005.
Man, coming out of the late rounds, you have to grind for everything. Nothing is given to you. And this guy has turned himself into a very solid big league ball player. That's a big accomplishment.
He lays out, but he can't make the play, and it's through into right.
Now back. Center fielder, Jason Kipnis.
Settling in now, Jason Kipnis. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Strike one to start the at bat. Brantley, base runner at first with one out. And there's ball one.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about. With the first baseman holding the runner on, it's always smart to pitch into the defense you have behind you.
Two balls and a strike now. The 2-1 home. On the ground is short. This could be two. Altuve for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is here. Digging in for his second at bat, Tyler White comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. First pitch coming, here it is. And that one just missed outside. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. The 1-1. Fly ball right down the line and left. Brantley is under it. And he hauls it down in the corner.
Now back.
Evan Gattis now standing in. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First pitch of the at bat. In tight here with the first pitch fastball. That's 1-0. Come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Bonnie gets him to wave at that one. It's 2-2.
Nice wave.
Another 2-2 offering. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The 2-2 one more time. Still even at 2-2. Another one sent foul.
Hey, I'm biased to the hitter right now. Keep frustrating that pitcher. Foul 12 of these things off. He's going to miss over the heart of the plate at some point.
Here now the 2-2. Hit on the ground out to short. Played on the backhand. On to first, and there were two down.
How about it?
Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First offering on its way. Leaves a slider up high, but it's taken for a strike. Swing and a hot shot toward third, and that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases.
And now this is thrown wildly, just getting it into the infield.
Wow, he almost blew that fastball by him, but he shows some quick hands to catch up to it and drive it down the opposite line. Didn't keep it fair by much, but he did, and that's a nice two-bagger.
From the stretch. In the dirt, and now let's see. Throw goes to third, and he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
Astros center fielder ahead with a 2-0 count.
Remember, he was a strikeout victim last time up, but this at bat seems to be a totally different direction. He's showing good patience now, and he's got a real good count at 2-0.
The 2-0 on the way. Now a pitch swung on and missed. It's 2-1.
Hey, this pitcher better watch himself right here. The way this guy's swinging, he's got aggressive things on his mind.
Set and the 2-1 pitch. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Astros lead one, but they're on top 1-0. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Jose Ramirez, set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. First pitch on its way. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. That's by him for strike one. Ramirez, a 25-year-old, this is his sixth season for him in the big leagues. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. A high fastball is in there.
Let's go, Cleveland.
Hard hit ball to second. Altuve fields it cleanly, and that's the first out.
Now back. Third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. First pitch coming, here it is. Way in front of that fastball. Into the corner and slicing foul. No runs, three hits, no errors to this point for the Indians. He'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. The 1-2. Fly ball out toward left center field. Springer has a read on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting, shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
In now for Cleveland, Francisco Lindor. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Here's the first pitch to him. And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. Right over the middle, knee high. Now the 1-1 pitch is a sinker that dips below the zone for a ball. Hit in the air out to right. Right fielder is on the run. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Tribe. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Now at the plate, number 3. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one.
Number 3.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. And that catches the outside edge, 1-1. One ball and two strikes to count. Swinging and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
Boy, there's the perfect pitch right there, the straight changeup. He hadn't used it yet in this at bat, and what does he do? He uses it, pulls the string, and gets the big strikeout.
Into the box, Alex Bregman. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. The windup and the 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Fastball called strike, 1-2. One out, nobody on. The next 1-2 pitch. And he'll stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. One and two, here it comes. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. And the slider misses here, so he runs the count full, 3-2.
That's back-to-back breaking balls away, but now he's got himself into a little bit of a tough spot. You probably can't throw that again, so your opponent is probably up there just looking for a fastball that he can drill.
Hit sharply on the ground. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
First baseman, Julian MVP.
Digging in once again, Yuli Gurriel. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Here's a first pitch changeup that swung on and chopped foul right at home plate. One run on 3 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. breaking ball over the outside corner for strike two.
Stay on the attack if you're the pitcher right here. You know who's lurking, 3-4-5, and you'd love to see that number three hole hitter lead that next inning off.
And it's fouled away.
He was able to foul that one off, but you could tell he was definitely late. That breaking ball, the pitch before that heater right there, definitely threw his timing off.
Gurriel behind, a ball and two strikes.
He's going to have to make adjustment on that slider away. He can't just make it a non-competitive pitch and allow these guys to take. He's got to start that a little bit more over the middle of the plate to get that swing and miss on the outer half.
Here's another 1-2. They try to come in with a fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2.
This kind of hitter right here, we call this guy a grinder. What are grinders? They just kind of foul off some good pitches. They lay off the pitches just off the plate. This is every pitcher's nightmare.
Well, the first baseman is under it to make the play, and that retires the side. Astros go down 1-2-3, but they lead it.
Leading off for the Tribe, right fielder, Melky Cabrera.
And the pitch. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. Cabrera, a native of the Dominican Republic. He's in the midst of his 14th major league season, so I guess you could say baseball has been good to him.
Yeah, and that's the name of the game with this guy. You don't hang around 13 years. I always say this, you show me a good teammate, I'll show you a guy who opens the door every day, and you know exactly what you're getting. The consistency this guy has had can't go unnoticed, and he's had an amazing career.
The 1-2. It's a changeup that drops below the knees for a ball.
He got ahead with two good fastballs and then tried to drop the changeup to see if he'd be out in front. Did a great job of laying off that pitch right there. Interested to see where he goes now.
He stays alive, still 2-2. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
If you're ever going to see a position player go to the mound, it's going to be in a situation like this. Get him to relax a little bit, focus on his mechanics, and get that fastball back in the zone. Can't allow this guy to lead off wall.
High pop-up. Correa is under it. One out.
First baseman, number 10, Edwin.
Now in the box, Edwin Encarnacion. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. First pitch of the at-bat. Missed with a slider.
Pretty good pitch and a great take there. There's not a lot you could do with that slider breaking down, and unless you can catch it way out front and hook it down the line, you see a lot of swinging misses on those.
A fastball down near the shoe tops. The 2-0 is in there for strike one.
Love the pitch call there. 2-0. You know the guy's geared up for a fastball, and you drop a changeup in the zone, that's going to be a tough pitch to handle.
Now the 2-1 is in there for strike number two. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
I think one of the keys, Matt, you want to try to initiate contact. The one thing you don't want to do, you don't want to run the count to three balls and two strikes. Whatever you want to throw, throw it over for a strike. He just sports that ball off the wall, and now the question will be, should he have continued on or not? He thought about pushing it, I'm sure, but decided to play it safe. It would have been close, but I think this time he's probably right in staying at first.
Ready for another chance? Eric Gonzalez looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. First pitch coming. Here it is. A high fastball is in there. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. A wave and a miss. Encarnacion stands at first with one out. Swinging a soft liner. That's his first base hit, making one for two now. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
You know, it's funny, the first two strikes are for the fans. You're trying to put balls in the seats right there. With two strikes, it's for the team. You got to shorten up and find a way, and that's exactly what he did right there. Soft liner into right field for a base hit.
Into the box now, Roberto Perez. As he'll look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. Runners are at first and second with one away. Ripped down the first base line, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Hit down the third base line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. The 1-2, high and deep to right center. On the move is Springer. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away.
Left fielder number 22.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Michael Brantley, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. And this is low, ball one. Two men are on with two men out. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
That's a real good job of going back-to-back fastballs right there. Most of the time, a hitter will see a fastball in the inside half of the plate, and they'll just think, well, this pitcher's going to go back on the outside. But when you double up like he did right there, it sends a message to the hitter that you're not afraid to throw in that inner half of the plate.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two. Pops this one up. Correa calls for it. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. Indians strand a couple. They still trail 1-0. Adam Simber takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 90.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Leading off for Houston, second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Looks at a two-seamer right down the middle.
To me, getting ahead 0-1, it's the most important pitch in the game, Matty. It puts the hitter on the defensive. I can only think of myself being in the batter's box. When I'm sitting 1-0, I am all over the gas, or I am allowed the opportunity to sit on something without fearing going 1-1. When you're down 0-1, your head's on a swivel.
hit on the ground to third. And that'll get by into left field, so he's on to lead off the inning.
Well, that's not a bad pitch right there. That's a pretty good sinker. He just happens to hook that one right into left field for a base hit.
Yeah, he got the bat head out right there, Dan, and was able to get that one to left field.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Starts him out with a sinker that's inside, 1-0. The 1-0 doesn't catch the outside corner. It's a ball.
This is why I love having athleticism and speed on your team. You can tell the runner on first base is certainly messing with the mechanics of the pitch.
A dive, but he's back. And another throw over. And he'll get back in safely. A runner at first with no outs here. And again a throw over and the runner back safely.
MVP, MVP.
Now the 2-0 is swung on and missed, strike one.
MVP.
The 2-1 is in there for the second strike. Nobody out, runner on first. High fly ball out to deep right field. Looking up is Cabrera. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Carlos Correa with a two-run shot. His first homer so far in the series, and the Astros have taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Now batting, designated hitter.
Tyler White will bat next.
Nope.
Ball one. No hits to this point.
Let's go, drive. Bang.
Ball and two strikes. Here it is. And that slider's almost in the dirt.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Cabrera on the move, but he doesn't have a chance. It's over his head. And they'll keep it going here as he's in with a double.
He was able to spit on that first slider right there, guys, but he didn't let the second one go. Able to execute and drive the baseball.
Evan Gattis now standing in. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
And this is not an easy play when you have to range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
Cleveland rocks!
First offering on its way. Tough slider down low for a strike.
Hey, I don't have a problem with him taking a pitch right there. It's a good opportunity to see what he's got. Also a good opportunity to see if he's going to be pounding the strike zone. If you could work a couple walks, it could be the start of a big inning.
comes set with the 0-1.
D-Rod.
Took a wave at one around the shins with no luck.
Hey, two pitches at the knees right now, and you're down 0-2. This is where you got to fight. I want to see a two-strike approach. Maybe a little choke up, maybe a little fight up the middle the other way. Grind back into this count.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. And that sinker misses at the shoe tops, ball one. White takes his lead at third with one away.
Get him down now.
And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
Here's George Springer as he'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one. 0 for 2 for him to this point. The 1-0 is a sinker that misses for a ball.
We've seen him go down on strikes more than once in this game, so this has been a better approach by him in this at bat. Much more patient, and he's gotten himself into a good hitter's count.
Now the 2-0 is laid off, but in there for strike one.
We got two balls, one strike.
Looking good, Indians.
D-Rod. To 2-2 now. Into center field, line drive, base hit. And the run is in to score from third.
Outside of taking a ball in the seats, Dan, these were my favorite knocks to get. Two outs, man on third, and you're able to upset that entire team, including that pitcher, with a late two-out ribby knock.
And so frustrating from a pitcher standpoint, D-Roy. You're in trouble. You're one pitch away from getting out of some trouble. Make one bad pitch, a base hit. The inning continues, and another run batted in.
Standing in now, number three. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. Three runs already home here. Two balls and two strikes now. Just got a piece up the line. On to Encarnacion at first, and that ends the inning. But they strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's now 4-0 Houston. So striding forward now, Jason Kipnis. And Dan, he and his fellow top of the order hitters haven't really offered much help for this lineup so far.
No, your 1-2-3 guys are the ones you look to generate a lot of action. And they just haven't been up to the task so far in this one. Still time for them to turn it around, though. We'll see if it happens.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Here's a strike. Now the 0-1. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. Hopped up. Gattis has a play, and that's the first out of the inning. Striding forward now is the DH, Jose Ramirez, 0 for 2 on his line thus far.
I mean, what a diamond in the rough Jose Ramirez has been for Terry Francona and the Cleveland Indians. This guy burst on the scene in 2016, just absolutely set that lineup on fire. They were looking for a guy to bail out Michael Brantley and the production they would miss from him in the lineup, and Jose Ramirez filled that admirably.
The windup and the 0-1. And this is bounced foul at the plate, and that moves the count to 0-2 now. Couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
You know, he's one of their guys they rely on to get their offense going. They need a rally, so we'll see if he can spark one here.
The 1-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Again, a 1-2. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
That was aggressive pitching in that at bat, and I like seeing that. He showed all hard stuff until the fifth and final pitch for the strikeout. When you work off your hard stuff, it really opens up your secondary pitches to be more deceptive.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. A hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. A 1-1 count now to Donaldson.
Hey, nice adjustment right there for him to get on top of that baseball and drive it to the corner. The first pitch he obviously tried to overthrow got under it, and it sailed on him a little bit.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. Two out, nobody on. Hold the string on him. Strike three swinging. Gattis recovers, and that ends the inning. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On to the seventh now in game three. It's the Astros 4 and the Indians nothing. Back here in Cleveland, on to the seventh now in game three. But before it gets underway, we take a look at our game summary through the first six. Neil Ramirez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 58, Neil Ramirez.
And that'll bring up the former first rounder Alex Bregman. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. And that misses ball one. And that one misses upstairs, 2-0. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. Yuli Gurriel waits on deck. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey.
And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four. At the plate, Yuli Gurriel. He was retired after popping out in his last at-bat. First pitch coming. Here it is. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here.
This is where he might need a mound visit, whether it be from the shortstop, his pitching coach, or the catcher. These last couple of pitches have certainly gotten away from him.
There goes Bregman off of first. A ball and two strikes now. Ready to deliver the 1-2. And a fastball just a bit high. Grounder down the line at third. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. The 2-2 one more time. This one is fouled away up to the concourse area.
Hey, he's got four foul balls in this AB right here. He's really making this pitcher grind for everything.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. Digging in and looking for more, Jose Altuve. He singled his last time up. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. And he chased up and out of the zone. A swing and a miss.
It's amazing. I tell so many fans, you get in a box one time, the one pitch you're going to swing at more than any other is that elevated fastball. Your eyes light up as an offensive player, and you just cannot get to it.
The 1-2. Oh, and he misses it. Dan Otero comes on to pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh. Carlos Correa will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Thought he had the inside corner that time, but it missed for ball one.
This is the guy they're going to have to be careful with. He could put three runs on the board in a hurry, so expect them to try to get him to chase something out of the zone if they can.
What are you kidding me?
They get him off balance there as he reaches for that one but can't find it. It's 2-1. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. Bregman on second. Altuve is over at first with one away. To the right side and through, a base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away.
Hey, this guy's having a big series in the postseason. It looks like to me that the moment isn't too big for him. He's slowing the game down. He looks terrific.
Yeah, absolutely. Postseason monster right here, having a huge series. Any big leaguer can have their moment mid-May, but to do it when it gets cold outside means everything.
And this is just off the outside corner for a ball, 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Hey, I'm a little shocked right there. Double play situation. He doesn't go with the sinker. He goes with the ordinary fastball in that situation.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Bases are loaded with only one out.
Strike.
into right center field, and this ball's going to get down, a base hit.
One run scores. And the second run will score as well, as they've opened it up to 6-0 now.
Hey, listen, when you have a good sinker, you have to throw it, but he's going to have to get the ball much lower in the zone than that last one.
Yeah, from the offensive side, Dan, two-seamer, pitcher, sinker, baller, what have you, you're looking for that thing to pop out above the belt, and that's exactly what happened right there. Miss middle.
Popped him up. Gonzalez is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now, and there are runners at the corners now.
Marwin Gonzalez.
First pitch on its way. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Runners on first and third, two away. And he looks at a ball, one and two. Looking to minimize the damage here. Still a ball and two strikes. Hit on the ground to third. Donaldson's there. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and two men left on base. Stretch time here at Progressive Field. The Astros on top, 6-0. Now it's the all-world, all-star shortstop Francisco Lindor. 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon.
Matty, he checks every box. Charisma, smile, hits from both sides of the plate with pop, defense, you name it. GM's dream right here.
At the plate, Melky Cabrera.
Melky Cabrera.
Here's the first pitch to him. In the dirt here. And no advance. It's ball one. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Fastball just a bit low here. He's behind 2-0 now.
You can't allow this offense to get going right here. Leadoff man on doesn't kill us. Let's try and roll a double play right here. Let's execute a good pitch down and away. See if we can get a ground ball and rely on your defense a little bit.
Two balls and a strike to Melky Cabrera. The 2-1. Takes this the other way to right. And Cabrera is going to have himself a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second, as there are two aboard now.
Hey, this might be their best opportunity to at least get on the board. They've been struggling offensively, and they find themselves with two runners on board. Let's see if they can continue.
Edwin Encarnacion now. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he takes a pitch right down the middle.
We're moving right along into this one. This guy's continuing to pitch well, which is a little bit of a surprise because his first pitch strike ratio is still under 60%.
And this one's in the dirt. So now two men in scoring position.
Well, you live by the sword, you die by it too. He went with an off-speed pitch down in the zone, and that's the risk you take there. The catcher can't come up with it, and two runners advance. Now they're both into scoring position.
The 1-2. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down at first and no swing. It's ball two. Popped up. Gurriel is there for it. One out.
Great scoring opportunity miss right there. You talk about frustration. Popping it up with two runners in scoring position. He'd like to get that one back.
Coming to the plate now, Eric Gonzalez. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. A changeup that catches the corner for strike one. Lindor on third. Cabrera at second with one away. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
And he comes back with a fastball. One and two now. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. One left for the Tribe. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Cody Allen enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
Cody Allen.
Standing in, George Springer. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Leading off for the Astros, center fielder.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
George Springer.
Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. And this is a fastball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now.
When you're down 6 on the mound, you got to at least throw strikes here.
And he fouls this one off. Now the 2-1 pitch. Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here now the 2-2. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate. The 2-2 one more time. Fouled away. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
First pitch on its way. Up around the face. Action going on now in the Indians' bullpen as they have a left-hander up and getting loose. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. The 2-0 on the way. He's looked at for the first strike. Hit hard to third. Donaldson's up with it. Throw on to first. Two gone.
How about it?
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Alex Bregman. He's hitless in his 2 at-bats so far. First delivery to him on the way. And He misses inside with that one. Ball one.
Obviously, the game plan wasn't to let this guy beat you right here. He's already walked twice, and that pitch out of the zone tells me they want nothing to do with him.
A ball and a strike to Houston's leadoff batter. Bases are empty here with two men out. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. The 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. 1-2-3 go the Astros. But they're on top by a count of 6-0. Chris Devinsky is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 47.
Stepping up to the plate, Roberto Perez. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Pitch on the way. Lays off the slider and it's 1-1. A fastball right down the middle for a strike. And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here and it's back to 2-2. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. And there are the final numbers for the Astros starting pitcher. And he really delivered a fantastic postseason performance. Here's Michael Brantley head-to-head against Chris Devinsky. He's hitless in 3 at-bats. Here's the first pitch to him. Called strike over the outside corner. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. And 2 strikes.
Great job on those last 2 pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball and then he locked him up with a changeup.
The 1-2. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Right fielder has a beat on it. 2 down.
Now batting.
So coming to the plate, Jason Kipnis. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Here comes the first pitch. A little tapper. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. So they breeze through this half of the inning. On to the 9th now in game 3. Houston leads. Oliver Perez comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Digging in, Yuli Gurriel. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. First offering on its way. Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball 1. The 1-0 is a slider looked at and called a strike.
Oh, he thanks his lucky stars right there getting away with that hanger. I cannot believe he didn't pull the trigger on that pitch.
And that one right down Main Street. popped him up. And no one will get this one. Here he comes again, 1-2. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball. And a neck-high fastball that time. Here now the 2-2. It was laid off and the count runs full. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
Here comes the first pitch. He takes a knee-high fastball. The matchup numbers with Oliver Perez. He's 1-for-5. And that misses, 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Now here's the pitch. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down, maybe even potentially bounce the next one.
And this is popped up back behind second. Lindor backs up and takes care of it. Two away. So here's the cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa, who went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4 to this point. First pitch on its way. And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. Two out, nobody on. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. The throw into second. And now, gracious, just getting the ball back into the infield is becoming a problem.
Wow, he must be living right because he gets absolutely jammed. Thought we were going to see the bat splintered, but instead, he muscles the ball to right for a double. Might get some heckles from his teammates, but no doubt, he'll take it.
And now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike one. Line drive to left. And that's going to get down out there. And the rout is officially underway. It is 7-0.
I mean, that had to feel good right there, Dan. That's his third RBI of the game and extends his team's lead. They might have this one locked up.
Well, I tell you, those are always big, those add-on insurance runs. Big RBI right there for a little bit more breathing room.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Takes a high fastball for a strike. Oh, and one, here it comes. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball, ball one. White, the runner at first with two gone. Grounded down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. The 1-2. fouled off. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. Two out with the man at first. Slider, and it's off his glove, and it bounces away. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch. Another full count pitch on its way. Count remains full. He'll try it again, 3-2. And that misses, ball four. So it's first and second now with two out. Ready for another shot now. Marwin Gonzalez. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Looking to minimize the damage here. A ball and no strikes.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
It's 2-0 to Marwin Gonzalez.
Well, that's another great hitting count here on 2-0. It's no wonder why they're up 7.
Over the outside half, and it's 2-1. Three balls and a strike to Houston's left fielder. George Springer would be next. The 3-1. Swung on and missed, and that's a full count now. Three balls and two strikes.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
And this is fouled at the plate. This one's down to third. He's got it. On to Encarnacion at first, and that ends the inning. Astros forced to settle for only the one run. Part of the order, 3, 4, and 5 will get their shot in the bottom of the ninth. The Astros lead it 7-0. Colin McHugh, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound. Ready now, Jose Ramirez. He'll lead it off with his guys needing a ninth inning rally here if they're going to force a game four. Here's the first pitch. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood in a broken bat.
Now the 2-0.
Ball three.
Ball three.
Reno.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
Ooh, I'm shocked he took that pitch right there. That ain't plus 90s right there. That's mid to low 90s fastball in the
high in the air, carrying well out to deep center. Back goes Springer, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And the Indians have an early threat here in the inning. It's a leadoff triple. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Lifetime history with Colin McHugh. He brings with him a .313 batting average. He's also hit 3 home runs. Here's the first pitch. And this one's down off the shoe tops, 1-0. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Springer has a read on it. makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And he will get in to score, and it's a run batted in on the sacrifice fly.
Great job of offensive execution there. Leadoff triple, and then the sack fly to bring home a run.
Here's the first pitch. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike.
Clean slate on the base pass after that sack fly a minute ago, so now's the time to be aggressive with these hitters. Go right after them and try to get out of this inning with only one run scored.
One out, nobody on. Indian shortstop behind one and two in the count.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate. That's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
So he throws him for the strikeout. Francisco Lindor goes down, and they've got only one out left to work with. Here's Melky Cabrera, and their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out.
Nope.
4-1. And here's his fastball for a called strike one, and he's hitting an even 90 on the gun.
Get there.
Bases are empty here with two men out.
Hey, Cabrera.
Last strike now for Cleveland. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strikeout there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. And a breaking ball stays outside.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking for the final out. That's a tough pitch to lay off. Impressive that he did.
Full count still. Ready with another two-strike offering. Hard hit at third. Bregman has it. And start the celebration. The Astros are off to the ALCS.
Well, they know their work is nowhere close to being finished, but they've handled their business so far, winning here to punch their ticket to the ALCS and a possible trip to the World Series. Well done.
And they did some damage offensively in this one, enough to get the win, and this man led the charge. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, no question, he was a tough out up there. Ended up collecting three knocks, including a home run. So without him in the lineup, I think this might have been a different story.
For the left-hander Dan Plesac, Mark DeRosa, and our entire crew, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been the American League Division Series.
Fans, our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Astros. 7 runs on 12 hits. No errors. They left 9 runs.